All right, so the man sitting to the left of me is back in the UK.
Yes.
And his name is Drake, and you're talking to Kiss. How's it going, sir?
I'm good. I'm happy to be here, man. You know, I love being in London. It's great.
Well, the sun's out for you, which is good.
Which is amazing, because I don't think I've ever experienced the UK when it's not, like, grey.
Yeah, it usually is grey.
So, I mean, it's beautiful out here, definitely.
Sun is out for you and it is all good. Well, I've got to big you up on the show, man.
Thank you.
Paradise Tour in full effect.
Yeah,
sold out the O2 two nights in a row.
Very
18,000 people.
Yes.
So when you look out into that crowd, do you find that your fans have changed with you over the years? Are the people that surprise you that you see in the crowd?
You know, I see familiar faces often. I see a lot of new people. I think the craziest thing that's happened is my music has pulled in a lot of older people. So, you know, I'll see like couples. You know, last night there was a couple kissing, you know, up in the boxes, and I was like, wow, those people have to be like at least in their 30s somewhere, you know?
Yeah.
That's crazy to have people come out. Because, you know, I remember when I first started, it was very much like, you know, an internet-based, very young, very, you know, knowledgeable underground crowd. And now it's become worldwide. And they told me, like, incredible things about last night. Like, we could have done another night, you know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely.
So, I mean, it's pretty special.
Well, no, I remember the moment when you stopped and you said, you know, it feels so good to call my mom.
Yeah,
and let her know I sold out the O2 two nights in a row.
It's
going to get even bigger because you're doing the Barclaycard Wireless Festival in July.
Yeah.
You're headlining.
That's going to be
65,000 people.
Yes.
You ready for it? What are we going to see?
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to bring the same show. I mean, not the same show, but I'm going to bring the same energy, you know, the same performance I give. Super excited with all the other acts. You know, Nicki's on there, Rhea is on there, The Weeknd is gonna be there. So I'm extremely excited about Wireless. I wanna, you know, bring in a big, incredible set. I'm gonna change the set, it won't be Club Paradise,
it'll look
different. And hopefully I have some new music out by then, or at least like, you know, one or two new songs to really beef up the set and make people go crazy.
So. That everyone can sing along to.
Because
the interesting thing that I've noticed about the crowd is that I think obviously it's easy to get girls to like you.
Yeah,
you're doing all right that way. Yeah,
that's
I think
nice.
So. We're getting
that's
along.
Nice compliment.
So this is cool.
Yeah, no, that's
but
cool.
I think with dudes, especially with hip hop, it's, you know, they usually like either rappers, it seems, you know, historically they're either super, super tough and super, super thugged out or, you know, or are so introspective to the point where, you know, they're looking like to their rappers like philosophers, but you seem to toe that cool line where guys seem to have a massive guy crush on you at the moment. Like, no, but this is the thing. Like, you know, I talk to my male friends, they're just like, yeah, man, Drake, he's so deep, da, 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 da. And you'll hear them pause, but you'll hear them talking and they're just like, yeah, man, I just love him. I really feel him. I really relate to him. Why do you think it is that your guy crowd relates to you so much?
Well, I think that, you know, one of the best parts about my career is like, you know, I don't have to wake up in the morning and like say to myself, okay, I gotta remember to talk like this and act like this because I'm playing a character, or I gotta spend 3 hours getting ready before I could go out in public because, you know, people have only seen me. Like, I mean, I get to wake up and be myself.
Absolutely.
And, you know, I think amongst men, I think that there's like, you know, there's some people that hate it. You know, there's some people that can't stand it, that say it's too emotional and he's too this and he's too soft and he's too
They're
that.
Just upset because you're showing them up.
I mean, or it's just like, you know, there's some people who like aren't comfortable in their own skin. So they like maybe lash out at other people who are. But I think for the majority of men, there's just like a mutual respect. When you see another dude who's like, you know, doing his thing, who's, you know, getting girls, you know, who's doing a great job at getting money and he's doing it all by being himself. You
absolutely.
Know, I know that goes for me. Like when I see somebody else, like even when I see my friends, you know, like that's my best friend right there. You know, I have the utmost respect for him because, you know, he's swagged out. He does his thing. You know, and he has his life together. Mm-hmm. I always respect like another man when I see that in him. So, you know, I mean, yeah, I think that's got something to do with it.
That's
why
dudes relate.
I don't know if it's a crush, but I think it's like it's a comfort level. You know, it's like guys can come to the show and realize, okay, you're gonna see girls, which is a great place to be. And then, you know, aside from that, I mean, you can come there and not feel uncomfortable, even when I'm singing the R&B songs.
Mm-hmm.
I try and make it music that it's okay for guys to sing along to and listen to. There's like aspects of it that's a bit ignorant.
Mm-hmm.
It's not sappy. It's like, you know, there's just like, there's things that you can relate to as
it's
a man.
Dude music.
Yeah, a little
bit. That the ladies like.
Yeah.
I mean, you touched on the fact that you're making a new record at the moment, or you're thinking about it at least.
Yeah, I'm just sort of at that place where I'm collecting beats. I recently just did some work with 2 Chainz.
Oh, cool.
You know, he's an incredible artist from the U.S. that's buzzing right now. Mm-hmm. But aside from that, just collecting beats, I'm actually supposed to go see Jamie XX tonight if
I
get a moment.
Oh, wow, that would be dope.
So we can...
Because obviously you have the Take Care connection.
So we can take it, you know, take it even a step further and start doing it. So I really want him to have like a big presence on this next album. And you know, 40's back home working on an incredible project right now. I can't wait to get back there and work with him. So yeah, just really, it's more right now about building the canvases, the song, you know, the beats, and then we'll start writing.
I see. Well, I did see you tweeting Mavado lyrics earlier, so you're gonna have a dancehall influence on the record,
maybe. I'm a big dancehall fan. You know, I spend a lot of time in Jamaica. And Mavado is family to me. You know, and I love everything. You know, Free Up World Boss. You already know. I'm just a big reggae, big dancehall fan. So yeah, I feel like there was influence. On Take Care, you know, with the actual
song. With the steel drums, of course.
You know, just trying to, I'm not too into like the 4 on the floor techno house feel. Mm-hmm. I love house music, mm-hmm. but for me to get to that tempo, I feel like that's like what every artist does. Mm-hmm. You know, in America, they feel like, oh, if I want to be worldly, I got to go make a song with David Guetta.
Absolutely.
Or I got to go do this. And, you know, not to say that he doesn't make incredible music, but for me, I'd rather get with somebody like Jamie XX and bring that soul and bring that island feel to it. That's when I start getting into the faster tempos. So I'm looking forward to doing more of that, though.
Well, London Carnival's coming up soon, so you know everyone's going to be dancing to that on the planes.
Yeah,
getting all jiggly.
Yeah.
I mean, speaking of the Caribbean connection, we've got to talk about your homegirl, Rihanna.
Yeah.
She's in the UK right now. Now, we saw the other day that you guys hit the club. But I was thinking, do you do anything that's kind of like, quote unquote, normal that we don't know about? Do you guys play Scrabble together when you hang out?
That's funny.
Or maybe Battleships even?
Oh, I guess Battleship would be good now that she's in the movie, right?
Absolutely.
do we do it? Yeah, I mean... I guess over the duration of our knowing each other, mm-hmm. I think we've done some normal things. I don't know if we've ever played board games, but I mean, I know we go bowling a lot. Nice. Not necessarily with Rihanna a lot.
Okay, just you and your crew.
We've been bowling before. And then, you know, I love doing like just, to me, the club is work, you know, the majority of the time.
Mm-hmm.
So I like to do things like go to the arcade and play mm-hmm. games, or go bowling, play ping pong. Go go-karting, paintball, mm-hmm. which we haven't done because these guys are scared.
Okay.
Because I'm the best, you know what I'm saying? My squad is the best.
You're the best.
I'm the, you know. but yeah, so, I mean, we do things to have fun all the time.
I see. I mean.
I see you wrote down Scrabble and Battleship.
Yeah, I did, because I had to remember, look.
Right.
I've got to remember my jokes by numbers, but hey.
I think we're in the same building. Maybe I'll ask her if she wants to play Scrabble.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, Drake and Rihanna themed Scrabble.
That's kind of sexy.
Yeah, sexy Scrabble.
You never know where that could end up.
Just using rude words.
Yeah.
But anyway, we'll keep it PG-13, kids. Okay. I mean, well, talking about like, other people that you've been working with, Rita Ora, she dropped R.I.P., which is a dope tune written by you.
Yes.
How did that come about?
Me and Rita have known each other for so long. Actually, mm-hmm. you know, I will say, one of the greatest gifts I ever received in my life, I wear it every day, is this ring right here.
Okay.
They tried to talk about this ring the other day and say I got married to somebody, which I didn't.
Okay.
But Rita actually gave me this ring as a gift. We're dear friends. I love her very much.
Yeah, she's a damn girl. We like her.
She is. Yeah. And R.I.P. actually, to be honest with you, was a song that I originally wrote with Rihanna, like for Rihanna.
Okay.
I wrote it with this girl from Toronto. Her name is Shy Wisdom. She's like an incredible artist. She helped me with some of the words, and you know, Rihanna didn't take the song. I think it was actually for the album before this one. Mm-hmm. And Rita, you know, expressed interest in it, and anything I could do for Rita, I will do. So R.I.P. is now her song, and I heard that it's buzzing out here in the
UK. She's smashing it, man. People love it. Obviously, Tiny's on there too,
so
it can't hurt.
She's
doing all right. Yeah. I mean, UK connection, you know, it's Labyrinth for supporting you.
Yeah.
And he came in our studio the other day and he said, you know what, I'd love to do like a collaboration album with Drake.
That's crazy.
Kind of in a Watch the Throne kind of style. Would you be down for that?
That'd be kind of dope. I mean, I'll tell you, I've been watching him open up and he is absolutely incredible. Like, you know, he, like, you watch openers and you say to yourself, oh, he's good, or that person. But Labyrinth came out there to the point where I was like, yo, I gotta have my stuff together tonight. Mm-hmm. This guy's playing every instrument, jumping around. Mm-hmm. I was like, you know, I gotta really come out there and kill it because my opener is killing it. So
Don't be too good.
I mean, he's really great. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think it would be great to collaborate. I love his sounds, and whenever I'm in my dressing room warming up, you know, his voice is always coming through the the vents, you know, I can always hear, I can, his voice travels. So I think it would be great to really, to get some music done. That'd be cool, yeah.
Well, last two couple of questions. I got to talk about your fellow Canuck, Mr. Justin Bieber, another one who dropped through the studio. Mm-hmm. Now he was telling me that you are working on the Believe record.
Yes.
And you two have got a really interesting, I guess you've had quite a similar background because, you know, you've both been quote unquote teen stars, coming up with you doing the Degrassi and him coming out of his, I guess, teen pop phase. And he's moving on to the next level. So was it important for you to kind of reach out to him, to work with him, to kind of
Been really tough for me is the fact that I really wanted to get some solid time with him on this record, and with me obviously having a promo cycle going on right now, it's been really hard for me to, we've actually only spent one night in the studio unfortunately. I was trying to spend like a week and get some great songs for him. I heard his single the other day, it dropped, and I'm really proud of him. You know, it sounds like a growth.
Absolutely.
And yeah, I wrote one song, and I believe I'm supposed to finish it this week.
Okay.
I'm supposed to get back what he did, and so we're kind of working long distance, but I mean, you know, that's somebody that I've always looked out for. Obviously, both being Canadian automatically bonded us, and then just getting to know him and, you know, everybody around him. He has a great team, and he's really, you know, a great person, so we get along very well. It's like my little brother. So.
Oh, wicked. We look forward to hearing that.
Him and Jaden. Jaden, too. I got to shout out Jaden. That's Will's son, too.
You know, look at you, how you're Jayden. Rolling.
You know, I mean, those are my little dogs right there. Those are my dogs. They're coming up, man. Jaden's doing his rap thing, and Justin's doing, you know, Justin's obviously Justin Bieber.
Absolutely.
So. But those are my little brothers.
Yeah, so you know, when they hit 21 years old, they're going to be trouble.
Oh, yeah.
But speaking of you.
That's when we can have some real fun.
I'm sure. Will, you
that's when Will's going to be calling my phone like, wait, y'all are where? What? Doing what?
Leave my kid alone. Right. I mean, you've hit the grand old age of 25, which you were speaking about, you know, in full last night. Mm. And you were saying, you know, with artists in the hip-hop
hit the ground.
Game.
What does that mean? Like I'm old?
No, not hit the ground. I said you've hit the age of, the grand old age of.
Oh, yeah. No, it's not grand. Let's not, hey.
Okay.
Listen, 25 is young.
Sorry, you're at the sexy age of 25.
Yeah, thank you.
You're at the sexy age of 25.
Youthful and sexy.
Yeah, sexy and senior. Sexy 25. Age of 25.
Yeah, yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
When you look back, looking forward to the next 25 years, what do you want to look back and say, you know, I did this, that, and that? What are the three things you would have liked to have achieved by the time you're 50, if you can imagine that far?
I'd like to say that I bettered the life of my family and friends, which I'd like to think I'm well on my way of doing. I'd like to say that I made an iconic impact on my generation, like a Bob Marley did, like a Jimi Hendrix did, like Aaliyah did, you know, like, you know, icons, people whose faces still sell on t-shirts. I want to be that iconic, like Michael Jackson, you know, like... So yes, I'd like to think that I made an iconic impact on my generation. And I mean, I'd like to, you know, also think that we sort of changed the way music is done. You know, I mean, it's not all about, you know, I don't think music and being successful at music is that far off of a thought for kids anymore, because back in the day it used to be like, well, if I don't meet this big record producer and I don't get this big label behind me, I'll never be famous. And now, you know, with what me and 40 did with So Far Gone, as far as releasing it on the internet and kind of shooting straight to stardom, I mean, I think that kids realize that the internet is the most powerful tool that we've ever had in music, and that's all you need.
Absolutely.
So I'd like to sort of, when people think back on it, I hope they remember me for sort of somewhat pioneering that movement.
Well, on that note, Drake, we look forward to the next 25 years.
Cheers.
And thank you for talking to Kiss.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Nice one.